everyone. Thank you very much for being watching this video of today. You are watching In a New School. My name is Veronica, and thank you very much for watching this video and being part of this project. So the topic of today is related to this beautiful image that we have here. Yes, the topic is the music. The music as a didactic resource for teaching and learning English as a foreign language. Have you ever tried to use music or use songs, rhythms in your classrooms? Not only to teach English as a foreign language, but also to teach culture, to teach social knowledge, to teach mathematics, or maybe to teach geography. Yes, you must be thinking, wow, all the possibilities that music offers to us. As you know, music is one of the main elements that teachers we can use in order to connect the learning of English, the English learning, with the interest of our students, because we are surrounded about music input. We can listen music in the radio, as part of the movies, on TV, and learners receive this input unconsciously. So, moreover, this is a resource that offers a very motivational activities. They are learning vocabulary, they are learning English contents in real context. They are learning from songs that they like because they can dance, because these songs transmit to them good vibes or good feelings, good emotions. And I think that music is the few elements who connect people from different cultures, different languages. We can be together listening and liking the same song. Maybe we don't understand completely the lyrics of this song, but we are enjoying listening to this song. So, as a teacher researcher, I think that music offers a very fruitful value to our didactic strategies. And now we are going to summarize the main ideas of the investigation that Kodaly did at the beginning of the 20th century. So Kodaly was a teacher and was a teacher researcher who promoted the music teaching in early kids. So he defended that kids received 1 hour per week of music education at schools. In order to continue with this ideology, he had to demonstrate the effectiveness of music. So he started a series of investigations comparing the results of a group of students who received music classes every day of the week with one group who only received music sporadically. So the results were very valuable because he demonstrated that music, on one side, music helped students to work on their self-control, to learn how to be more tolerant, to learn. Music helped students to develop their sensitivity. But moreover, music also helped students to improve their deficiencies in language, in mathematics, and in other areas different from music, because music was connected and it helped students to learn different kind of contents through the music, through the rhythms, and through the songs. There have been several researchers after Kodaly, but today we want to focus on this researcher and this important teacher in the music area. And I'm going to ask you to share your opinions, share your experiences as a teacher, because I think that we can learn from each other. And I am really interested in what you have to do, what you have to say about this topic of today. How can we use music to teach English as a foreign language and to teach cross-curricular contents? Thank you very much, and I hope your response, and we are going to be in touch next week. Thank you very much.